When we first started 10 years ago, technology seemed to have solved pretty much all. AutoCAD had tools for every problem we could imagine, so hand drawings were already dinosaurs for us. Then we saw a lot of versions come and go, even faster than what we could learn the new features that year. Early in the game, we realized that it was not going to be enough. The very first 3D parametric systems and softwares came into play, and we saw the very first embryo of BIM technologies, even though we didn't know it at that time. Evolution is a gradual process, but we all know that from time to time there is a discrete step, a discrete jump that changes the status quo. BIM solutions, not Revit, not Bentley, not ArchiCAD, or any other tool specifically, but BIM as a concept of grabbing building information and developing a database model, is a discrete jump, and a certain one, not just another fashion that we'll forget about the next coming season. Now, to solve a problem, you first have to make sure there is a problem, and when the problem is real, you first need to define the problem and understand the problem before attempting to solve it. Many ask the question, should I change AutoCAD for Revit? Or is it Revit or ArchiCAD? Probably the very same way they ask themselves, should I change hand drawings for AutoCAD a few years ago? But I believe we are missing one crucial stage, a critical question that needs to be answered before moving on to the next stage. And that is to BIM or not to BIM. That is the question. We are talking about changing the way we think, the way we plan, the way we organize our teams, the way we conceive work, and the way we deliver. Imagine an old carpenter working with his screwdriver. He knows the tool and he knows how to use it. He's been doing it for years. But then an automatic screwdriver comes into play and makes his work easier. It's easy. He knows how to use it. It only improves the existing condition. But years later, electricity opens new doors and brings new tools. Imagine him trying to use a new electric tool with his very old paradigms. That's not going to work for him, so he needs to make a paradigm shift. New tools, new paradigms. That is why to BIM or not to BIM is the real question. When this dilemma is solved, decisions are easy and processes flow smoothly. We have seen this challenge over and over. It requires commitment and conviction. But before trying to plan how to execute this change, we must first understand how to think about that plan. Many people have helped us along the way, so if there's anything we can do to make this easier for you, just let us know and we'll be more than happy to help you.